Hello and welcome to this video about CBSE Class 10 English First Flights Chapter 4, which consists of a poem titled, Amanda, written by Robin Klein. The poem is about a little girl named Amanda who is constantly instructed by her mother for making mistakes. The poet has beautifully expressed Amanda's feelings in the poem about how she is controlled and directed by her mother for small things. The poem conveys an important message that children should never be deprived of their freedom. And it's the responsibility of the parents to bring up their children in such a way that they understand their viewpoint instead of getting frustrated. In the first stanza, the poet says Amanda's mother is pointing out her mistakes and asking her not to bite her nails. Then she tells her not to bend her back and shoulders. She scolds her for walking in a lazy way with her head and shoulders hanging down and directs her to sit straight. By listening to all this, Amanda starts getting frustrated by her mother and starts imagining herself to be in a deep green sea. She imagines how blissful her life would be if she were a sea god having a fish tail instead of legs. Then, she would have enjoyed the sea waves and moved along with the waves up and down in the water. In the second stanza, Amanda's mother is inquiring whether she has completed her homework or not. Then she asks her whether she has cleaned her room or not. She is also reminding her to clean her shoes. At this moment, Amanda visualizes her life as an orphan. She thinks that being an orphan, she can freely roam in the street. She has the freedom to peacefully draw designs on the soft dust with her uncovered feet. There is no one to say anything to an orphan, so she can have a silent, peaceful life full of freedom. Here, the poet says that she gets so irritated with her mother that she thinks the opposite. Her mother was advising her to clean her shoes so that she could live a hygienic and healthy life. But Amanda took it in another way that her mother is snatching her freedom. That's why she starts imagining that the life of an orphan is better than hers. In the third stanza, you will see Amanda's mother is not allowing her to eat chocolates. Whenever she eats chocolates, she gets pimples on her face. Her mother then tells her to listen to her when she is speaking. She wants Amanda to pay attention to her words and follow them. After listening to her mother's words, Amanda imagines herself to be Rapunzel, a character in a fairy tale. Rapunzel was captured in a tower by a witch. The witch used to climb the tower with the help of Rapunzel's long hair. So, Amanda wants to live Rapunzel's life as she feels that she can live a calm and quiet life in a pleasant environment. But, she will never let her hair down to anyone so that no one can enter the tower. In the last stanza, Amanda's mother warns her to stop behaving in an odd manner. She says that she has become moody and is always in a bad mood. If anyone notices this, then they will feel that her mother is harassing her. The poet wants to convey that Amanda can't even react to what she feels about her mother. If she does so, her mother will take it against her sense of pride and scold her to behave properly as other children do. Here, Amanda's mother nature is shown to be very dominating. In conclusion, the poem, Amanda, conveys a powerful message about the importance of not depriving children of their freedom and bringing them up in a way that they understand their parents' viewpoint instead of getting frustrated. We hope you enjoyed watching this video and gained a solid understanding of the chapter. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more interesting videos like this. Thank you for watching.